Good morning. Welcome to SR Pharma again. Today we are going to discuss about the glucagon and insulin. In our last video, we have discussed about the different pancreatic hormone and diabetes mellitus. So first we'll start with the glucagon. Glucagon, it is a 29 amino acid peptide which is secreted from the alpha cell of the pancreas. Now, isolate of the Langerhans composed of the almost 15 to 30% of the alpha cell, 60 to 75% of the beta cell majorly. Now, this alpha cell, it is responsible for the secretion of glucagon. Glucagon, it is playing an important role in maintaining of the glucose hemostasis by increasing the blood glucose level. So first, we should discuss about the synthesis of the glucagon. Proglucagon, this is the precursor of glucagon. And this proglucagon, mainly it is expressed into the pancreas, that is to the alpha cells, then intestinal enteroendocrine cells, that is the L cells, and brainstem and the hypothalamus. Though in the brainstem and the hypothalamus, only a lesser extent of the proglucagon is expressed. Now this proglucagon, if we are talking about the pancreas, that means pancreatic alpha cells, in presence of PC2 enzyme, that means prohormone convertase 2 enzyme, it will convert into the different hormones and their fragments. So for example, this is the GRPP, that means glycogen related pancreatic polypeptide, then interwing polypeptide 1 or IP1, then MPGF, a proglucagon fragment, and mainly the glucagon. So proglucagon, in presence of PC2 in pancreas, it will convert into the glucagon along with the some other fragments or the product. Similarly, if we are talking about now these two sides, that means intestinal enteroendocrine L cell and the brainstem and the hypothalamus, there proglucagon in presence of prohormone convertase 1/3, that means PC1/3, they will convert into the glucagon like peptide 1, GLP1, GLP2, IP2, and also about the glycogen and the oxytomodulin. So these are the, you can say that, conversion process of the proglucagon to glucagon and GLP1. Next we are going to discuss about their functions. Glucagon release is stimulated by the number of the factors. For example, hypoglycemia, prolonged fasting, exercise, protein rich food. These are the some key stimuli that enhances the release of the glucagon from alpha cells. But in the same time, so there are the some of the inhibitory stimuli are also there, which reduces the release of glucagon. For example, glucose, somatostatin, insulin in the direct effect, free fatty acid, ketone acid, GLP-1. These are the some of the factors which consider as a inhibitory stimuli, and that reduces the secretion of glucagon. Now, if we are considered that hypoglycemia, it is one of the important stimuli of glucagon secretion. Now, how it is produced, we are going to see. Now, if we are considering the reduced blood glucose level or hypoglycemia, that means whenever there is a hypoglycemia or reduced blood glucose level, that also cause decreased in the glucose level in the cellular level. That means intracellular glucose level will be reduced. Whenever there is a reduction of the glucose level inside the cell, it will also affect the ATP generation, and they will reduce the generation of the ATP. Clear? Generation of the ATP. Now this ATP, when their production it is reduced, what will happen? As a result, that is the potassium channel, which is governed by this ATP, that means which is regulated by the ATP, it will inhibited. Now, as we know that inside the cell, generally potassium level is high, and in the resting membrane potential, if we are considered, and whenever there is a opening of the potassium channel, potassium go outside. Now, due to the decrease into the ATP, the potassium cannot go outside because this channel was blocked. That means intracellular level of the potassium is increases. Level of the potassium intracellularly it is increases. Now positive charge increases inside the cell, it is cause the depolarization. It will cause the depolarization. Now due to this depolarization, this will trigger the calcium to come inside the cell. Clear? Depolarization result the calcium to come inside the cell through the opening of the calcium channel. This calcium now inside the cell, and as a result intracellular calcium level it will be increasing. Intracellular calcium level it will be increasing. Now this calcium it will be cause the exocytosis. That means the glucagon, this is the glucagon which is stored into the granules, due to the increased level of the calcium, through the exocytosis it will be released. So this is the process through which glucagon is released in when there is a hypoglycemia. So this is the mechanism of the glucagon release. Now if we see about the glucagon release, if we plot the graph here, we can say that this is, you can say that picromole per liter plasma glucagon level. If we are considered the plasma glucagon level and in the considered as the time, we can see that this is the normal. See, this point is the normal level of the glucagon secretion. That means after the one steady level, there is a reduction of the glucagon release, and then again it will be increases. So it is into the normal. But if we are considered the type 1 diabetes mellitus, clear? Type 1 diabetes mellitus, that time this glucagon level it will be rises, and then after some time only it will be decreases slowly, and again there will be rises. That means glucagon concentration it is be more into the type 1 diabetes mellitus released. Type 2 diabetes mellitus also, we can see here a peak in where the glucagon secretion it will be rises, then it will be again slowly it will be decreased, again it will be rises. So this is the glucagon secretion in normal condition, that means in healthy individual, in type 1 diabetes mellitus patient, and in type 2 diabetes mellitus patient. Glucagon involved into the carbohydrate and the lipid metabolism majorly. Now if you see about the glucagon, glucagon opposes the action of the insulin. Clear? It is opposing the action of the insulin and also regulated the carbohydrate metabolism. That means it is increasing the blood sugar level. Clear? It is the increases the blood sugar level and reduces the level of the glycogen. Clear? It is reduces the level of the glycogen. And if we are talking about the lipid metabolism, it is increases the level of the free fatty acid in blood. Clear? In blood. Now if we are talking about the what are the effect of the glucagon in the different organs of our body, what we can see that in brain it is responsible for the reduction of the appetite, it will reduces the food intake, and it is also reduce the satiety. In case of the pancreas, it is promoting the release of the insulin and somatostatin. So glucagon is responsible for the increase of the insulin release. So insulin release increased by the glucagon, as well as the release of the somatostatin. It is promoted by the glucagon. Next, coming to the adipose tissue. If we are talking about the adipose tissue, the resting energy expenditure, it will be increased by the glucagon. And if we are talking about the glucagon effect into the heart, what we can see that glucagon is responsible for the increase into the heart rate, increasing the contractility, and the increases the cardiac output. So heart rate, contractility, and cardiac output, it is increases by the glucagon. Now coming to the liver. Now liver is the most important target or the major target of the glucagon, because it is regulating the carbohydrate metabolism. So in case of the glucagon, it will increases the production of the glucose. So glucose production, it will be increases by the glucagon. In the same time, breakdown of the glucose, it will be reduced by the glucagon. Glucagon is responsible for the reduction of the breakdown of the glucose. Breakdown of the lipid enhances by the glucagon, and production of the lipid in liver, it will be reduced by the glucagon. So breakdown of the lipid, it will be increases, and production of the lipid, it will be reduces. Other than that, ketone body production. It will be enhanced by the glucagon, whereas breakdown of the amino acid, it will be increased by glucagon in liver. Other than that, the glucagon also responsible for the increase into the bile secretion. Then also you can say that inhibit gastric acid secretion. So these are the major effect of the glucagon into the different organs of our body. Now we are going to discuss about the mechanism of action of glucagon. Of course, some of the major functions of the glucagon. Now glucagon, it acts on a G protein coupled receptor, glucagon receptor, which is a G protein coupled receptor, and as it is a G protein coupled receptor, of course it will be present into the cell membrane. Now this is we are showing about the glucagon receptor. Now glucagon receptor, GPCR, and it is composed of the major 3 subunit, that is the alpha, beta, gamma, and GS subunit, that is the G protein. It is attached to the alpha subunit. So when the glucagon, it will bind to this glucagon receptor, it will cause the activation of glucagon receptor. As a result, there will be the dissociation of this portion, that is the alpha portion, GS protein, it is attached to the alpha portion, and there is a, you can say that, transformation from the GTP to GTP. This, it will act on the adenyl cyclase. And it will cause the activation of the adenyl cyclase by the alpha subunit. As a result, from ATP, there is a formation of the cyclic AMP. There is a formation of the cyclic AMP, one of the major second messenger. Now this cyclic AMP, it is responsible for the phosphorylation or the activation. Phosphorylation or the activation of protein kinase A, PKA, and also cyclic AMP response element binding protein. Yes, that is the cyclic AMP response element binding protein or CREB. Clear? CREB. Now, what is the function of this CREB? This CREB, after the activation, it will act and it will enhances the glucose 6 phosphate. Clear? It will increase. That is responsible. This CREB responsible for the increase of the glucose 6 phosphatase and increase of the phosphoenol pyruvate carboxy kinase. Clear? Phosphoenol pyruvate carboxy kinase. So from the cyclic AMP, PKA and CREB, PKA also responsible for this activation of the CREB. The CREB is responsible for the increase of the glucose 6 phosphatase and phosphoenol pyruvate carboxy kinase. Now, whenever there is an increase of the glucose 6 phosphatase and the phosphoenol pyruvate carboxy kinase, it will result gluconeogenesis. Clear? It will cause the gluconeogenesis. Clear? It will cause the gluconeogenesis. So this is the important, one of the important effect of the glucagon, that is the gluconeogenesis. PKA also responsible. Clear? PKA also responsible for the phosphorylation of phosphofructose kinase 2. It is responsible for the phosphofructokinase 2 and fructose 2,6 biphosphate. It will cause the activation, phosphorylation of this phosphofructose kinase 2 and fructose 2,6 biphosphate. When is there is a activation of these two, this phosphofructokinase 2, after activation there will be the inhibition, it will cause the inhibition, but there is a activation or the promotion of, clear, promotion or the activation of, that is the fructose 2,6 biphosphate. And as a result, clear, as a result, what will happen? The level of the fructose 2,6 biphosphate, it will be reduced. Clear? Fructose 2,6 biphosphate, it will be reduced, whereas fructose 6 phosphate, it will be increases. Clear? Fructose 6 phosphate, it will be increases. As a result, it will cause the glycolysis. Clear? As a result, it will cause the glycolysis. And here, whenever there is an increase of the fructose 6 phosphate, it is nothing but the again, it will promoting the gluconeogenesis. Clear? It is promoting the gluconeogenesis, that is the fructose 6 phosphatase. But due to the decrease into the fructose 2,6 biphosphate, there is a glycolysis. So again, glycolysis, it is one of the major effect of the glucagon. PKA also responsible for the phosphorylation of pyruvate kinase. Clear? Phosphorylates the pyruvate kinase, PKA. Whenever there is a this phosphorylation, this is phosphorylation is nothing but the here we are talking about the activation. So whenever this activation it will takes place, that is fructose 1,6 biphosphate it will be increases and pyruvate it will be reduces. Fructose 1,6 biphosphate increases, pyruvate it will be reduces, and as a result it will cause the glycolysis. Clear? It will cause the glycolysis. PKA also responsible for the phosphorylation of phosphorylate kinase. That means phosphorylate kinase, it will undergo the phosphorylation or the activation induced by the PKA. As a result, glycogen it will be reduced, whereas glucose 1,6 phosphate, glucose 1,6 phosphate it will be enhances, and this is again it is starting of the glycogenolysis. PK also responsible for the inhibition or decrease into the or inhibit glycogen synthesis. So this is overall effect of the glycogen. So if we are summing up in a nutshell, we can say that this glucagon act on the glucagon receptor, which is a G protein coupled receptor, so formation of the cyclic AMP. Then it is activating the phosphorylation of the PKA and CREB through the production of the increase into the glucose 6-phosphate and phosphoenetol pyruvate carboxykinase. It will promote the gluconeogenesis. Here PKA through undergo the phosphorylate the pyruvate kinase, so that pyruvate it will be reduces and it will promote the glycolysis. Here also PKA phosphorylates, that is the phosphofructokinase 2 and fructose 2,6 biphosphate. As a result, increase of the fructose 6 phosphate, it will promote the glucogenesis, and decrease into the fructose 2,6 biphosphate, so again the glycolysis. PKA also inhibit the glycogen synthesis and also phosphorylates phosphorylate kinase. As a result, glycogen it will be reduced and glucose 1 phosphate it will be produced. So this again the glycogenolysis. So glucagon it is playing important role into the gluconeogenesis, then glycolysis and glycogenolysis. So this is all about the glucagon. Other than that, I am also mentioning some of the important references which you can go through for elaborate understanding if you have required in the description box. Thank you.